Okay. Hello. So, after a while of just trying out different things, I finally got my Ableton to work with recording. So that means I can record in Ableton with not just voice, but also with music. Yeah, we have brass and everything. Wow, that sounded so real. So, what I'm going to be going over is a beat recreation that I posted a while back on Instagram of Bobby Brown's On Our Own. Now, you may recognize this song if you ever seen Ghostbusters 2 because it's the featured song in that movie. And the music video for this song is like, it's cool. It's like a Ghostbusters 2 80s thing or whatever. He's popping up on billboards and all that good visual effect magic. So I thought that would be a great topic for a first video. I can go through different instruments and kind of see how this works out. So, first things first, I'm gonna just go ahead and play it. So, yeah, when I was recreating it, I just kind of made those, that little short intro part rather than the whole song because I wasn't really trying to focus on the melody, but getting sounds as close as I could get them. I'm going to start from the drums here. I'm going to go through, the process of how I was looking for these instruments and that sort of deal. And you'll be able to kind of hear these isolated for drums. This is in that New Jack Swing style, which was a style that was really popular during the 90s and actually kind of had a resurgence with some more recent hits by Bruno Mars. But this style for the drums, a lot of times the drums are sampled, but fortunately, because samples, finding the exact sample that somebody used for their drum can be pretty tricky. This is actually a drum machine sounds, and that drum machine is the Lindrum, which, while not as popular as the 808 or even the 909, both by Roland, the Lindrum was used in quite a few songs. Prince used it quite a bit. If you've heard A-ha's Take on Me, it was the drum used for that song, the drum machine used for that song. So it was used in quite a few hits, but because the Lindrum drum machine sounds come with Ableton, it was very convenient. So the first thing we notice here, if you can see here, the pitch is very adjusted. You can see plus 15 there. Whoops, let me select the drum here. Right? Now as I make that lower, you may find that more familiar, but the snare is really pitched up for this. Now the kick isn't really adjusted too much. Negative one. So, almost more of a nuance, especially compared to that snare. So the snare is also layered. I don't know exactly how they labeled it, but I was able to get a bit closer by layering a Lindrum clap and this kind of random snare sample that sort of has a clappiness to it, but I mainly put that in there for the high end. Still have the cymbals to consider here. So for here, I actually used a Lindrum and I used an open hi-hat sound from the 707, which I think I mentioned. No, I mentioned an 808 and a 909. A 707 is another Roland drum machine. So an interesting thing about this cymbal pattern is how it pans. It kind of jumps between the left and right channel a bit here. Yeah. So we have the drums. Now we move on to the bass. So that bass sounded a little bit recognizable to me. It sounded a lot like a Moog. So I used a Moog bass, and I actually did get pretty close. But something was kind of missing there. That didn't quite sound right. Oh, maybe it just needed to be down an octave. Yeah, I think this is gonna be- but that didn't quite sound right either. So what I did was I combined those two. So I have the Moog bass, I have the bass pattern, and then I simply have a copy of that, but it's pitched down an octave. So I was able to get a lot closer to the sound by using that extra octave there. And finally, the brass synth. Oh my, okay. So that's probably not much like the brass instrument that they use, but I was able to kind of get it closer by adding a chorus effect to it, because if you listen here, there's kind of a bendy sort of thing going on, a wavy sort of sound. So I was like, okay, how can I get that? Oh, a chorus. Because if you play around with a chorus, you know, you can get that sort of thing. We have this very thick chord. And the last thing about the brass, which is kind of odd, it's really out of tune. It's really detuned. As you can see here, I had to detune it quite a bit. I'm gonna slowly tune the brass back to its default pitch. I'll play it by itself too. Yep. So that is just a run through of how I recreated that beat and, you know, tried to get close to the sounds. It was interesting to do, and it's something I might do in the future. I've done it like a couple of times before, and I always learn a lot. I may not employ the same techniques when I'm making something on my own as when I try to recreate something, and I can run into new ways to get sounds. So, thanks for watching, and have a good one.